judicial system, we believe strongly that it will minimize corruption, which has been endemic.
Last week, the head of judiciary and Chief Justice Alphonse Owinyi-Dolo commissioned the Electronic Court Case Management Information System, ECCMIS, which will help fight case backlog and improve delivery of justice.
This is yet another milestone to minimize corruption in the judiciary, so that person-to-person contact is minimized.
The system had, however, attracted a lot of disapproval from a section of the public, with many questioning the procurement process through which it was conceived. Today, the Permanent Secretary to the Judiciary, Pius Bigirimana, elaborated on the procurement process in which Synergy Uganda was contracted to do the job.
I want to assure you that this system was procured with a lot of consciousness of those who are going to use the system, those who are going to benefit from the system. And we shall continue improving on it, because learning is a continuous process.
Bigirimana further revealed that besides the ECCMIS, the judiciary will soon establish judicial kiosks at most of its courts across the country to offer 24/7 surveillance to prevent any corrupt tendencies between litigants and court judicial staff.
These kiosks will be manned by the technical people or by those who will be trained to man them. And we are going to put cameras in those kiosks. Cameras, so that when you are handling these filed cases, we shall be watching what the person in the kiosk is doing.
The 9.2 billion shillings electronic court case management information system will see all case documents electronically filed online to minimize person-to-person contact. Although many had raised security concerns regarding the system, this, according to the judiciary, has also been addressed.
But in terms of the system itself, it is highly secure. There are many teams, there are many partners who are making sure that environment. We have recovery as well. People are not going to be able to lose their information. Even if the system broke down here, there is also another replication somewhere else.
In 1997, the judiciary embarked on the digitization process, including video conferencing, digital court recording and transcription process that speeds up the hearing process, electronic display board for cases, and now online filing of cases, among other digital transformations. However, for over two decades, this is yet to be realized. Story by Rachel Nachiwala for the news in Kampala.
Briefing, which we are here.